Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. Are you on the look for some new VFX for DaVinci Resolve? Well, maybe I have a solution for you. There's a lot of packs out there, and it's getting harder and harder to figure out which one you want to buy, which one is the right fit for you. So in today's video, we're going to test out the free pack from MotionVFX. If you are on a Mac, you might know the company if you were using Final Cut. They have done a lot of different things for that platform, but now they have started to do stuff for DaVinci Resolve. So very shortly, in this video, we're going to test out their free pack. It's kind of a pack so you can see how it works. Also, the way they install it is different than other packs. So that's what we're going to do in this video. If you want me to try out some of their other packs, write it down in the comments down below and I'll see what I can do about it. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get right into the video. Of course, if you are new here and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks, I would recommend you to subscribe to the channel. Okay, with that out of the way, let's jump right into this free pack. Okay, so first off, we're going to start up by going to MotionVFX homepage. And we'll go into DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to click that. Okay, so here we have all the different packs. We can search for whatever we want and stuff like that. But here we have the full list of all the items. We have some M16 stuff, some YouTube stuff, and there is actually a lot of LUT packs as well. So personally, I don't use LUTs that often, but if you're in the look for LUTs, well, why not? But what we're going to have a look at today is our free pack right here. And you're just going to click this and then you're going to be asked to install an installer. And that is working a little bit different because as soon as you've installed that, I'll just click mine up here. You can see that this is your dashboard for now on, and these are going to be installed on your system and in DaVinci Resolve. And there's no problem at all by importing them or installing them. It'll do it automatic and it's damn amazing. So of course there is also the thing, if you buy some of the other products, you are going to have two licenses. So it means that you can have all the same effects on two different systems, which in my case sometimes is very, very useful. So I did install the pack already, so I'm going to jump into DaVinci Resolve. And we're going to go up to our effects, we're going to titles, and we go all the way down to the bottom. We have the 6 free plugins you can play around with. And I think for what I tried already, I like the way they're working and how they are actually, how you can control them and stuff like that. So let's just jump right into it. So I'm going to take the DV avatar here, which you can use for different things. So if we go in here, we can see this is our plugin, but of course, as it is with plugins, we can change stuff around, which again, we can do in the inspector. All the different settings we can play around with, we have a content control where we can, you know, reposition stuff if we want to, make it bigger, larger, and rotate and stuff like that. We also have the drop zone controls, which is pretty fun. So if we go into this here, we can actually browse. So we're going to take this picture of me here and I'm going to put this inside here. And of course, this is too large, but we can, of course, change the scale and everything yet again to make it fit here. So we could take this and again, also mess around with this and change it so it fits your picture. And also, of course, we could change the text and the text font and all of that good thing, which I just think is pretty nice. So we can have a look here at the first effect here. So I think that is pretty nice. The next item here is a background. And as you see right here, you can again have a look at it. it's a motion background, and you can do different stuff. You can change the dots around, and you can also change the background control and the glow control. I don't know exactly what I would use a thing like this for, but I'm sure you could find some kind of a use for it. We are also going to have a DV bar here, so we can put that in here. And what we have here is a YouTube graphic, also pretty nice to have. And you can of course go in and customize everything for your liking. Again, the position, the text, and also you can change the icon. In this case, it's a YouTube icon, but you can go in and change this, for instance, to Facebook, TikTok, Twitter, Vimeo, whatever you want. For instance, if I did a Instagram text or something, I could change this to Instagram, and I could put in my Instagram account. But since we are doing YouTube, we might as well stay in YouTube. So this is a pretty good way to get your social media graphic into your videos super fast and pretty darn easy. So I do think that the motion VFX is very good if you don't want to do too much in Fusion, you want to save time. So in that case, it might be very good. So let's have a look at the logo here. So like that, and I think, again, this works pretty well. We have a logo control, which means we can, again, browse in. Let's take this one, put this in, like so, and we could then, you know, scale it up, do all kinds of things. We have a caption control where we can change that around as well. We can put in some more different text here, change the fonts, and we also have a background control, and that simply we could change the color if we wanted to let's say this color. We could then change the color. Well, that's not necessarily the color I wanted to. Could also could also take our color picker here and make, let's say, this color instead. I think that would be better, something like that. And we're still going to have the dots moving around. We also have some swooshes effects we can change. I think this is quite nice. So this is how that actually looks, pretty nice. Then we also have a lower third where we can go in and make our very own lower third. Again, we can go in to move this around and reposition. We have some title controls where we can change stuff around. And we also have this subtitle, which is right here. We can change that around as well. So overall, pretty good, nice stuff already. And here we have a title. Let's see what that looks like. Well, that's a pretty nice title, actually. And again, if we go into the title, we could change around the content, move it around. We could change the header text, which is right here. And then we have a title settings, which we can change here, change color, fonts, and all of that good stuff. So my first impression of this free pack is actually not that you're getting a lot of value for your money because it's free, but it's going to give you a pretty good look at Motion VFX's packs are going to be like. And I think they are full with great controls. And in my opinion, this is going to help you out if you are doing quick videos, don't want to use time on learning Fusion, or think it's too complicated. That's where packs like this are going to be just great. So I hope you like the video. Let me know down in the comments below if you want me to have a look at some of the other packs. I would love to. And well, that's it for this video. So I do hope you found it useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.